More and more alleged victims are coming out to reveal their harrowing ordeals supposedly suffered at the hands of Kingdom of Jesus Christ or KOJC leader Apollo Kibuloy, with deceit, manipulation, and sadly even with the consent of their parents. The supposed religious leader was allegedly able to get away with the sexual abuses on girls as young as 12 years of age multiple times. Patrick De Jesus has the full report.
To be haunted by the angels of death. This was allegedly the threat made to the victims of molestation and sexual abuse by KOJC leader Apollo Kibuloy if they revealed their experience. This is based on the testimonies received by the PNP from new victims who stepped forward. They claim to have experienced the abuse as young as when they were 12 years of age. The revelation also stated that such activity with Kibuloy was a fat to heaven.
Ang sinasabi, di umano, again, these are all allegations of nililinaw lang natin. Ang sinasabi na pagkatapos gamitin, di umano, ni Pastor Kibuloy itong mga bata, ang sinasabi sa kanila ay they are still pure, intact pa rin yung kanilang pagkababae dahil lang nakipagtalik sa kanila ay Espiritu ng Diyos. Ang isang sinasabi is Diyos ang kanilang pinagsisilbihan at kung ano man yung gagawin nila ay yun yung parang kanilang passes to heaven.
Not once, not twice, but multiple times, the abuse was allegedly committed and each victim had a schedule.
Itong particular na bata na to, ikaw ay pang Lunes, ikaw ay pang Tuesday, ikaw ay pang Wednesday, at paulit-ulit, not once, not twice. Just can imagine, 12-year-old kid, I don't know.
Some of the victim's parents, who allegedly are members of the KOJC, were aware of the abuse back then.
A 12-year-old kid being sexually abused ng paulit-ulit di umano ng isang tao na who's claiming to be the anointed son of God and using the name of God to sexually abuse, exploit children as young as 12 years old. For a parent to allow this, I don't know kung bakit nagagawa ng isang magulang ta i-offer yung anak nila in the name of faith.
In connection with this, the PNP is calling on other possible victims to come forward, assuring them of their security. An investigation is also underway to determine if the Angels of Death is an armed group. Kibuloy's legal team visited him earlier at the PNP Custodial Center where he is detained. The media asked about the new allegations. Kibuloy's lawyer insists the pastor is still presumed innocent until proven otherwise.
Kung may mga bago, I'm sure planted yung lahat yung mga manufactured yan, but let them prove their case kasi the accused is presumed innocent. Allegation is not equivalent to guilt.
Tolentino also stated that Kibuloy could not have committed the accusations hurled against him.
Kahit 1% chance hindi magagawa yan ni Pastor Kibuloy. Yung kaso, mag-base po tayo sa batas, mag-base po tayo sa jurisprudence, mag-base po tayo sa ebidensya, hindi tayo mag-base sa chismis.
Kibuloy and his team are also prepared for their arraignment tomorrow. The PNP then said that security measures have been set in place as Kibuloy and others are expected to appear physically before the Pasig RTC tomorrow morning, where the charges of qualified human trafficking will be formally read to them. The arraignment at the QCRTC, on the other hand, will be held via video conference in the afternoon in relation to child and sexual abuse charges. Patrick De Jesus from the National TV for a new and better Philippines.